supposed to die tonight. Niggas don't put a hit out and they talking like this shit okay. What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NY Phenom, the most anonymous voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go and subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew. Now, let's get to it. Listen. Give me Brady. Brady and the Buccaneers going to get this shit done, y'all. Listen. Buccaneers, Brady. All Bucks fans, you guys know how I rock with Bucks Nation. I do all your vids, all your game previews. I rock with Skull Gang. I rock with Bucks Nation. Just do your boy a favor. Knock off these dirty ass Rams on Monday Night Football. Knock them off down there in Tampa. Get busy. And do y'all thing. We just handle business versus the overrated Hornswoggle lad Frognose. Now Brady, go do your boy a favor and go knock off these overrated Rams. This guy Tom Brady, he owns the Rams. This guy Brady throughout his entire career has owned the Rams. Beat him in his first Super Bowl, beat him in this the last Super Bowl he played in. This guy Brady owns the Rams. He owns Jared Goff. Listen, I don't think this is gonna be close. I really don't. I think Brady and the Buccaneers, they're going to handle business on both sides of the on the field. Jared Goff doesn't stand a chance. This guy Jared Goff, he's not that nice. Even though they beat us last week, like I said, that was more about the defense shutting us down. It wasn't nothing about Jared Goff. Jared Goff had 0 touchdowns, 20 yards. Jared Goff really didn't do nothing. At the end of the day, it's not like y'all playing our defense. And listen, it's not even like y'all playing the offense. That game that y'all played us a week ago, all Jalen Ramsey had to worry about was DK. Because you know you had Tyler Lockett, Darius Williams do his thing on Tyler Lockett. Then you guys had the recipe to contain us. You guys can't do the same thing versus the Buccaneers. They got okay, word. Jalen Ramsey, you wanna shadow Mike Evans all night? Cool. AB, get busy. Chris Godwin, get busy. Scotty Miller, get busy. I know y'all can't guard Gronk. At the end of the day, the Rams have a tough time stopping the run. Ronald Jones just came off a 200-yard game. The Buccaneers are fun to dominate the Rams. I'm not trying to hear nothing about these overrated Rams. Oh my goodness, we beat the Seahawks. Oh, look at this defense. It's a top-notch defense. And oh my goodness, Brandon Staley. He's one of the best defensive coordinators in the NFL. None of that shit's going to matter to Monday Night Football. When Brady steps on that field with those weapons, with the weapons he's working with, it's GG. It's game over. Brady's going to get that ball out quick. Bucks fans got some good news because Ala Marpet, he's going to be back in the lineup, so that's going to be a good help when it comes to stopping and containing Aaron Donald. The Bucks got the recipe to beating this Rams team. This Rams team, they're running the same offense from the Packers. Sean McVay runs that same Matt LaFleur offense, so we know how the Bucks and Todd Bowles has performed versus that type of offense. They'll shut that shit down. All that play action bootleg shit is dead. One Shaq Barrett and JPP and Sue get out the golf. He's gonna struggle. He's gonna throw bad. He's gonna make bad decisions. And he's gonna struggle. Jared Goff struggles under pressure. He struggles under pressure just as much as Jimmy G. This guy Goff isn't the same quarterback when there's pressure around him. When there's no pressure around Jared Goff, he looks like a solid quarterback. He can make good throws. But then when the pressure gets there, it's GG. It's game over. Look at the Dolphins. Look at the Dolphins. When Brian Flores sent them dogs after him, Jared Goff, he was getting shit on. This guy Jared Goff had two turnover plays in his first possession. The Rams only scored 9 points. At the end of the day, that's the whole entire recipe when it comes to stopping this Rams offense, is getting pressure on Jared Goff. All Sean McVay wants to do is bootleg passes out the bootlegs and play action draws, and he's gonna want to run the ball in his outside zone bullshit. But that's not gonna work because Tampa got the number one run defense. Guess what? They got the pass rushers. They got JPP and Shaq Barrett off the edges. They got Levante David and Devin White up the middle. There is no way of the Rams putting up more than 17 points, y'all. At the end of the day, the Rams are gonna struggle. Jimmy G is gonna throw like 3 picks. There might be 5 turnovers overall. Carlton Davis, Sean Murphy, Buckley, and Jamal Dean. I like that matchup versus Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods. At the end of the day, y'all, this is a bad matchup. It's a bad matchup. It's in Tampa. It's a primetime game. It's on Monday Night Football. The last time that Brady played a primetime game, he got embarrassed. Brady's going to want to he's going to look at this as a revenge and prove to the national public that the Buccaneers are no joke and Brady's still the shit. So at the end of the day, this isn't close. The Bucs are the 4-point favorites. Take it. Take the points. Brady's going to dominate this Rams defense. I'm sorry. Listen, at the end of the day, if Aaron Donald's not collapsing the pressure up the middle, then the Rams defense has no chance. I don't care how good y'all think Jalen Ramsey and Darius Williams are. At the end of the day, the Bucs got too many weapons. They got too much shit. You can't guard Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, Gronk, Scotty Miller, and Antonio Brown. You just can't do it. Hell, we seen what Jalen Ramsey looks like versus Antonio Brown. We seen what that looks like. I mean, we know the Steelers choked away that game. We know Big Ben and Mike Tomlin fell on their face 3 years ago, but that divisional round game, Steelers versus Jaguars, even though Blake Bortles shit all over Mike Tomlin's defense, AB had like 3 touchdowns that game. So we seen what AB, what Jalen Ramsey looks like versus AB. He gets roasted and toasted. They just can't match up. They can't match up. So as long as in the day, the Buccaneers play patient, Bruce Arians and Byron Leftwich are just not earing the ball out down the field every single play, and they playing patient throughout, you know, through Ronald Jones and Leonard Fournette, through the running game and working off of play action, it's game over. It really is. It's game over. Once the Buccaneers go up 2 touchdowns and Jared Goff got to drop back, go in shotgun and do 10 step drop backs and get the ball out of his hands, it's game over. Shaq Barrett and JPP going to be on that ass, and those corners are going to be right there waiting for, lurking for the ball so they can get a pick 6. At the end of the day, if Todd Bowles comes out like how he should and play his aggressive, blitz-heavy, man-press offense, the Buccaneers should win this game handily. It shouldn't be close. They should win this game easily. It should be a game where they should be able... Listen, by the fourth quarter, Bruce Arians should be able to put in Blaine Gabbert. Brady should be able to take a break in the fourth quarter. So at the end of the day, Brady, do your thing. Ball out. The over-under is 48 points. I will actually take the under. Take the under because the Rams are not going to score. The Rams are not going to put up enough points, y'all. The Rams are not going to put up enough points for the Buccaneers. The Buccaneers will put up their 37 points. But the Rams... like I said, the Rams would be lucky to get to double digits. So for the safe side, I'll take the under for the 48. The over under is 48.5 points. I'm going to take the under, y'all. I just think this Buccaneers defense is going to be stifling. I think Jared Goff is going to struggle. And listen, man, the way how things are going down in NFC South in that division, like I said in my vid, y'all, Brady Buccaneers might really still win that division. The way how the Saints, they starting Taysom Hill. At the end of the day, yo, the Saints are going to probably eventually start struggling again without Breeze. So at the end of the day, the NFC South is probably still Brady's division. But, Bucs fans, Bucs Nation, y'all do y'all boy a favor. Do the 12s a favor. Go handle business versus these overrated, dirty piece of shit lambs. But that's all I really got to say, man. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm for number one. And I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt. Shout out my muddy niggas. K.
came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.